YouTube, what's going on? Trey back again, hit you with a video. Now this story is long overdue. This story is out of Florida, and I had Ben got requests on it when it actually first appeared on the Iyanla Van Zant show, Fix My Life. A big shout out to Iyanla. Also, I absolutely love that show. But they had a special guest on. The reason why I say special, because the whole dynamic of the story, the situation was very special. And the girl go by the name of Kamiyah Mobley. Let me get it right. I want to make sure. Mobley. Okay, Kamiyah Mobley, who is now, I think, 20 years old. She was born in 98. But anyway, she was kidnapped from the hospital. It was a big old story for those of you who are old enough to remember that story. It was a big old story in the news or whatnot about this girl being kidnapped. And they blamed the mother and the father for setting it up or staging or selling the girl off at birth, like we hear so many other stories. And some of these stories do be people actually losing their children. Now, some of these stories be on the latter end with people actually selling their children, but this family right here did not give her away, sell her. A woman by the name of Gloria Williams, basically, how can I put this, a heartbroken woman, down and out, wanted a child so bad and not in her right mind, because no matter how much you want a child and no matter how down and out that you are, you still do not have a right, and let me say this very clearly, to take anybody's child no matter what the hell you going through. And you know me, I'm gonna do my best to keep it real, but I'm gonna also be respectful at the same time. But you know, this story came to light just last week, because it's been almost 20 years to the date that Kamiyah Mobley was kidnapped. So the judge sentenced Gloria to 18 years in prison. Now it says this right here. It says, almost 20 years after she walked into the hospital room, Gloria pleaded guilty in February to kidnapping and interfering with state custody. Although the kidnapping carries a maximum life sentence in Florida, a plea deal limited her possible punishment to 22 years. And that was in February when she had her plea deal. But they had the sentencing, so she ended up getting 18 years. And then at the same time, she still was saying that Kamiyah Mobley is still her child, no matter what nobody say. Even though we know for a fact that Kamiyah is not Gloria's child. But at the same time, the story is not really about Gloria. It's more about Kamiyah and her mom relationship. The story goes like this. It's like her mom says that she wished that Kamiyah was never found and everything would just remain the same, because it's like her daughter do not respect her. Her daughter do not love her. And these are not my words. I will leave a link to the story in the description below. This is her exact words. I'm going to read a snippet from the story very soon. But before I go, do you remember how when she went on Iyanla Van Zant's show, how she basically cursed Iyanla out? And I never seen nobody talk to Iyanla Van Zant like that. Not saying Iyanla some high and mighty God. I'm not saying that nobody on this earth did. There's only one true God. So let's get that understood first of all, because I don't look at these people on TV like they something to be worshipped first of all. But I have respect for said people in their certain profession. But at the same time, you know how Iyanla try to offer little therapy sessions to people, and she go by doing it different ways depending on the character of the person that she's dealing with, because everybody's not the same. You know what I'm saying? Different strokes for different folks. So she had Kamiyah on the show basically trying to get Kamiyah to stay over. Now she didn't ask Kamiyah dad or the boyfriend, which I don't see what's the purpose of asking a dad or the boyfriend, because you know what you're on the show for. Just like Iyanla told her, you know what you signed up for. So a hoopla began going on, a big shouting match back and forth. Kamiyah, because she didn't want to stay. So Iyanla was like, how can I help you if you don't want to stay? And she'll basically tell the father, you know what I'm saying, whatever kind of dad he's supposed to be. And yes, I said that, whatever kind of dad that he's supposed to be, because even though you wasn't there in the child life from the beginning, it's not his fault. It's not like he was a deadbeat dad staying away. No, the child was kidnapped. You know what I'm saying? So we understand that. But at the same time, you supposed to offer correction, because she's in your life now. You still can offer correction. Not saying you have to be too hard on her or whatnot, but at the same time, you still have to know how to talk to people and respect people. Because let me tell you something. A lot of people go through things in life. Some get kidnapped. Some people got people murdered. Some people have been shot, stabbed. We all go through trials and tribulations down here on this planet that we call Earth. But Iyanla was basically trying to help this girl. And she totally rebuked everything that Iyanla was trying to do to her, calling Iyanla a fat bitch. Yes, said Iyanla was a fat bitch, and basically said, "I whoop bitches bigger than you." That part stuck out big as hell to me. I'm like, this child is full of so much rage and anger, and she's mad at the wrong people. She's mad at Iyanla. She's mad at her mom. But it's like she don't have any anger toward her dad. How are you gonna be mad at your mom and not be mad at your dad? Not saying that your dad did something wrong or whatever, because he didn't kidnap you or set it up, but at the same time, how can you have this much hate for your mom? And then now the mom, like, I don't want to have anything to do with her, she won't have anything to do with me, she won't respect me. Then you see a preview on the show how she basically acted, and it's crazy. And you know, like they said, the son was threatening Kamiyah, and I'm like, how? Because Iyanla's son is one of the cameramen on the Iyanla show, Fix My Life. He's one of the cameramen. They basically start talking about how the guy went to prison and stuff. Who cares if the guy went to prison? And the way they found out, if you might wondering, is the fact that when Kamiyah's dad and Iyanla's son got into it, that's when the words were exchanged. And basically, he told Kamiyah's dad that, look, I've been to prison before, you know what I'm saying? And you don't want to mess me, that type thing, how men talk when they get aggressive. So that came out, they put it all on the air, and they try to basically turn the whole story around like it was Iyanla's fault when you sign up to come on this show. But what man is going to sit there and let somebody just dog his mom out, threaten his mom, and then you the dad, you're not saying nothing? So quite naturally, the son's going to say something to you. He ain't no coward. Now, I'm not trying to start no mess, but at the same time, would you sit up there and let somebody cuss your mom out on national TV? I mean, let's just be for real. But at the same time, you could tell the child was a loose cannon. You could tell that this child was basically just off the hinges. But what I'm going to do is read a snippet from this story, go and dive deep into this video, and I'm going to get my opinion. Surely, as we go. Mother of kidnapped daughter explains why she wishes they would have never found her. Not my worst story. Now, Shanara Mobley, which is Kamiyah Mobley's mom, never stopped thinking about her daughter Kamiyah. July the 10th was always a sad day for her as she reflected back on the day that she learned that her daughter was taken from her arms by a woman who said she was a nurse. Come to find out, there was Gloria Williams, crazy ass, pretending to be a nurse. And I don't know what possessed her just to go up in the hospital and play like she was a nurse. I mean, damn, that's some other world type stuff right there. Now, Shanara never stopped praying for the day that they would be reunited. And when the day finally happened, it was not what she expected. Now, Shanara wishes that their reunion never would have happened. And a lot of y'all might be like, why? Hold on. Now, mother of girl who was kidnapped wishes they would have never found her. In January of 2017, Shanara Mobley learned that her daughter Kamiyah was alive and well. And you remember they had it all over the news. Now, she says in her own words, "It was one of the happiest days of my life," Shanara Mobley told the Florida Times Union. "It would be no difference if it was you and you had a long lost child. Whether you the child was kidnapped or whether you and the child had a big old falling out and y'all didn't speak to 20 years later. It's, you know what I'm saying? It feel like you done found a piece of yourself again, because that child is a piece of you. You feel me? You share the same genetics and everything." While Mobley was initially disappointed that her daughter didn't alert authorities that she had been kidnapped, Shanara decided to look past her disappointment. Apparently, Kamiyah learned that the woman she thought was her mother, Gloria Williams, was not her mom. After kidnapping Kamiyah, Williams raised Kamiyah Mobley, who grew up as Alexis Manigo. And why she picked the name Manigo, I don't know. They in the city, the place it happened, is in Walterboro, South Carolina. And all my peeps in South Carolina, you know exactly what that said. So now they stayed there until her arrest in 2017. Kamiyah did not learn her true identity until she discovered she could not get a driver's license without a valid birth certificate or social security card. This was information that Gloria didn't know and did not have, as she was not Kamiyah's true mom. And that's how the story blew open right there, when she needed a valid birth certificate and a social security card so she can get employment and furthermore go on if she wanted to pursue her education, go to college or whatnot. Now, when Shanara Mobley learned that Kamiyah was found, she was overwhelmed with joy, just like any parent would be. Shanara was ecstatic to hear the words she waited 18 and a half years to hear. "We found your daughter." She was also thankful to learn that Kamiyah was okay. She was healthy and living a good life. The happy mom and daughter that Shanara hoped for didn't happen. She thought that they would be a happy family, but that didn't happen. According to Shanara, on Mother's Day in 2017, 4 months after Mobley learned her daughter was alive, her daughter sent 2 Mother's Day cards to a Duval County jail where Williams was being held pending the outcome of her case. She didn't send one to Mobley. She didn't even send one to her own biological mom, because Kamiyah still associated Gloria as her mom, regardless of the fact that she knows and she hearing people saying, well, it's not your mom, but in her mind, in her eyes, that was her true mom, and she still look at this woman like that till this very day. And that's why we have this story right now, and that's why the mom said, well, you know what I'm saying, I don't want to have nothing to do with her, I wish they would have never found her. That, I know that sound kind of harsh to hear or whatnot, and I'm not here to judge the mom, but at the same time, you know, I understand both parties. I understand Kamiyah, what she went through. I understand the mom and what she went through. You know, it's just one big sad soap opera, if you ask me. But at the same time, why couldn't you at least send one to your mom, since you know that this is your real mom? That's what I don't understand. To each their own, though. But let's continue. Now, that was extremely hurtful. Sadly, this year was no different. Same thing this year. No card, no call, not even a text message. Shanara Mobley has now blocked her daughter from contacting her by cell phone, as her daughter is disrespectful. Because if she talks to her mom the way she talked to Iyanla, hell, I wouldn't want to talk to Anita. I'm just being serious right there, because regardless, you heard it also, and I heard it too. I heard it right along with you. And if you don't understand that, you don't understand English. The moment they kidnapped you, they kidnapped and took a part of me also. That's what the people is missing about this whole story. It's not only the fact that Kamiyah herself, you know what I'm saying, was hurting, but the fact that the mom was hurting also, you know. So we have to take that into consideration. And the mom also says, I don't deal with disrespect. She said through tears, I wish they would have never found her. That's exactly what she said. And life would have went on perfectly as it could be. But at the same time, now, at 16 years of age, Shanara Mobley had a first child that was kidnapped from her arms. You might say 16 is early as hell to have a child. And also, this is what was about to come out on the Yana Van Zandt show about this situation, about the child. What was the age of the father, and what was the age of Shanara Mobley, Kamiyah mom? Give me 1 second. Let me see. Can I find this real quick? What it says. I had a highlight of it. I have to probably come back to it, because I don't want to get the age confused. But the father is factually older than the mom. And they said basically the mom was a minor when the so-called dad started messing around with Kamiyah mom, and that he was a grown man. So that right there would have bust the whole scene open right there. And that's why it's alleged that they blew up on the show, that the father didn't care, and the father kind of went off, because that was going to get exposed. How old was Shanara Mobley, which is Kamiyah mom's, what was her age, and what was the father age, and what business did you have impregnating a teen? Let's continue. Life for Shanara Mobley had not been easy. She was just 16 years old when her daughter Kamiyah was born in 1998. Although teen pregnancy is often frowned upon, Shanara Mobley was still excited about being a mother. Despite her young age, Shanara felt that her pregnancy was a blessing, as well as the chance to stop her partying lifestyle and settle down. She probably just fasted, like, you know what people say, they don't like the word, but it's true. You know, we all done heard that, especially if you come from the South. You know, you're hot in the ass, sit down somewhere. You around here doing all kinds of stuff, sit down somewhere. And that's just what it is. I mean, come on, you don't get pregnant by being in the choir singing church hymns all day. Let's just keep it real. Now, however, her opportunity to be a mother to her child was taken from her by a woman named Gloria Williams. Some 18 years later, it was discovered that Williams kidnapped Kamiyah Mobley, and she was arrested. Back in February, Gloria Williams pled guilty to kidnapping charges and interference with custody charges. As part of her plea agreement, William faces the possibility of being sentenced 0 to 22 years in prison. That was before, but the update came out a few days ago where they had sentenced her to 18 years because she just went to court. And that's also the reason for this video also. Now, while Kamiyah didn't want Williams to spend any time in prison, her biological parents, Shanara Mobley and Craig Aiken, thought differently. They both gave emotional testimonies as to why they believe that Williams should have gotten the max. The prosecutor and Williams' defense attorney agreed to a sentence of no more than 22 years. Shanara Mobley has 5 other children who range in age from 3 years old to 15, but she wanted a relationship with her firstborn. However, she can't accept that Kamiyah still wants to be connected to her kidnapper, Gloria Williams. And this is where you have that Stockholm syndrome come in, where people sympathize with their oppressor, where people sympathize with people that capture them and manipulate them. It's just no different than you going to a jailhouse and you seeing guys, a prison, and you go to these prisons, and you see guys in there got 50, 60, 70 years. And guess what they doing? They running back telling everything to the CO, telling everything to the guards and stuff. Acting like these people are their friends when these people is on the other side of the playing field, but they can't see that because they have Stockholm Syndrome. They sympathize with their oppressor, with people who are over them. You know what I'm saying? Whether by force or by just natural habit. That's a form of Stockholm Syndrome, exactly, to the T. And it's the same way it is in these institutions, especially the metaphor I just used about guys being in prison. Because how could you sympathize with somebody who's there to keep you down, to keep you in that place? Even though they didn't put you there, that's not the point. The point is, they are the ones stopping you from walking out the gate. But yet and still, you can't realize that. So what you do, you sympathize with them and you tell on everybody. You do all kinds of stuff. You might call it brown nosing. You might call it kissing up behind them and all this other stuff. But anyway, you get the point. Now, the mom says, as long as she can call her and go see her, that's her mama. Shanara Mobley said, I'm about to start calling her Alexis so I won't be hurt. But pause right there. Now, mom, you have to remember one thing. Your child been through a lot. Your child been through a lot. This is no bash Kamiyah video. This is no bash the father video, even though he need to be talked about too. And why you messing with this young woman when she was a teenager? Because if you didn't, we would never even have this problem. Also, let's place the blame where the blame goes, but people don't want to do that. But anyway, mom, you have to understand that your daughter been through a lot. You have to understand the fact that you've been through a lot. But more than that, you are the mom in this situation. You are the adult. Even though Kamiyah is of age to be an adult, her mind is not functioning correctly as an adult should, because an adult means to be grown. An adult means to think things clearly, to talk things out, to rationalize problems and come up with a solution. You see what I'm saying? Because a problem will only remain a problem until you come up with a solution. But everybody's back pointing their finger at the younger, pointing their finger at the mom, pointing the finger at the dad, when all y'all need to do is have a therapy session. And that's what the Iyanla show was about. That's what they were trying to do, even though it's about to bust a lot of bubbles open too. But at the same time, this family need help and need counseling. But the mom, you telling the daughter that you're going to start calling her Alexis, and so you won't be hurt. So it's like a tug of war match, you know, because you looking at you, it's no connection there. Because if he was a connection there, somebody would say this: all right, look, I love you enough to let you go. You feel what I'm saying? Sometimes you have to let people go, whether they're your sons, your daughter, your husband, your wives, family, friends, whatever. Love them enough to let them go. You know what I'm saying? Because I love you enough to rather see you happy. Because one thing about it, I can't allow you to hurt me. But going back and forth, that gets you nowhere. Let's go and finish this story. The mom says, I'm serious. I have to start doing things where I don't hurt no more. If you want to be Alexis, be Alexis. If you want to be her child, be her child. This is a battle that I can't keep fighting. This is a battle that nobody is going to win. And that's fine. And that's a fact. That's a fact that she said that. But at the same time, you have to understand, you're the mom, she's the daughter, she's the child. No matter if she's 30 years old and you the mom, you could be 40 years old, you're still the child compared to your mom and your dad, and whether you like it or not. And that don't make sense. I don't understand why I don't. But at the same time, you supposed to rise above that. Put your feelings to the side. You know what I'm saying? Give her some time, because she just got found not too long ago. She just realized the truth. And that would devastate anybody. I understand that. Now, her being disrespectful with that mouth, hopefully she can work on that. But at the same time, all that is rooted in rage and betrayal. You see what I'm saying? Because she's really mad at Gloria Williams. She's not mad at you, Miss Shanara Mobley. She's not mad at the dad, Craig Aiken. She's really mad at Gloria, but she's taking it out on all the wrong people, placing blame on Iyanla, placing blame on her mom. And notice, she never blamed her dad one single time. Watch that. Anyway, let me know what you all think. And like I said, you know, let's keep Kamiyah, her mom, and also the father in our prayers. But at the same time, what age was he when this girl got pregnant? Also, we can't negate that, because records show that he was a grown ass man, and this girl was what, 15, 16 years old. Some even say 14. I don't know. I don't want to put no lie about it. But she couldn't have been no more than 16, because she gave birth at 16. He was already 20, 22. Maybe 24. But I know he was in his early 20s. Anyway, let me know what you all think about this video. And this just goes to show you that no matter what you do, no matter what you do in a situation is, if you tried and you gave your heart and you willing to love somebody and you showed them that you love them and they don't want to reciprocate that love, get that love back to you, just let them go. You know what I'm saying? Because that's love. Love is free. You know what I'm saying? You don't have to love me and be up under me. You don't have to love me, but respect me, though. You see what I'm saying? Just respect me. So I understand the mom don't want to be disrespected, all she done went through. But let me know what you all think about this video. If you like the video, push that like button. If you like the video, definitely share the video. Also, subscribe to the channel. And let me know what you all think about this situation right here. And like I said, big shout out to all my peeps in Florida holding it down. I'm going to holler at y'all later. I'm out.